everyone, I'm Norman Wildberger. There are a lot of viewers that would like to do some research kind of activities in mathematics. They're not necessarily PhDs or oriented towards academic disciplines, but they're amateurs and they want to engage in the creative side of mathematics. And I'm starting a new venture now where I'm going to try to guide and show people how to do real research in mathematics. So I want to lead you to the position where you can actually make interesting investigations and explorations. So this is going to be called Explore Research Level Maths. It's a new series that I have in mind. And it's going to be a series that's available for a channel membership on the Wild Egg Maths course. So I want to tell you that at the beginning. I'll tell you more about that. So I have two channels. Insights into Mathematics is my main channel with more than 700 videos, and it's aimed primarily at explanation, at showing you, you know, what mathematics is and going through all kinds of different topics and teaching you about mathematics. Then my other channel, Wild Egg Maths, formerly called Wild Egg Mathematics Courses, now called Wild Egg Maths, has about 100 videos. It's smaller, and it's mostly so far geared towards the courses that I'm developing, which have more of an active approach rather than the passive aspect of just watching YouTube videos. So it's in this domain here that I want to introduce this new development that I think you'll be really excited about. So in the Wild Egg Maths channel, I have a number of courses which are in preparation, and one of them is running. That's the Algebraic Calculus 1 course, and I hope a lot of you are thinking about joining it if you have not already done so. Possibly the world's most interesting calculus course. Then it's going to be followed by Algebraic Calculus 2 sometime this year, more videos. And then there's some other interesting new courses being developed. These are all going to be on open learning. Universal Hyperbolic Geometry, Geometric Linear Algebra, and the Algebra of Boole and Circuit Analysis, along with a more newer one called 6. So these are all courses that I'm currently in the process of developing. But what I want to talk to you today about is something a little bit new. A very nice question. Can amateurs successfully engage in mathematics exploration and research? I say yes. But the right orientation and instruction and guidance are crucial. And that's what I'm hoping to provide you. So people who have some motivation in mathematics, have some interest, have some basic, perhaps undergraduate knowledge, maybe they typically think, research in mathematics, it's so highbrow, it's so complicated, there's no way I could actually do that myself. But you are seriously wrong if you think that, okay? There's a lot of potential for ordinary people with some mathematical interest and motivation and maybe a small amount of ability to actually make explorations. And these are fun and interesting. And there's a serious potential for really discovering new things. Okay. Especially when you take the rather novel point of view that I have towards a lot of pure mathematics. I think a lot of modern mathematics research doesn't even really make logical sense. So for me, there's wide expanses that really need to be tackled and looked at very carefully. Okay, so in this new series, Explore Research Level Maths, I'm going to try to move from our current passive admiring and learning maths frame of mind to a more active doing maths, investigating, exploring, solving problems, writing up conclusions, interacting with other people, maybe having collaborations. Okay, this is, I think, so important to be ultimately be able to roll up your sleeves and actually get to work doing something yourself. That's the place where you really learn things deeply, and there's the potential for really satisfying activity that's so interesting and fun. I mean, I think being a pure mathematician is a wonderful gift. I'm so happy that I'm a pure mathematician because it is so interesting, and I have my days filled with interesting thoughts. And I think it would be great to share that with more people. not just at the, you know, the level sort of from a far distance, but actually right up close, the nitty-gritty, see how it actually works. All right, that's what we're going to do. So I'm going to have a very hands-on approach. I'm going to sort of imagine that you're sitting at my desk and the computer is open and I'm saying, okay, let's have a look at this problem. Let's do this. Let's do that. Well, we'll need this tool here maybe, or maybe here's a sub-problem that we need to first work out, you know. And so it'll be hands-on. It'll be exploratory. We'll go down dead ends, no doubt. We'll make some mistakes and have to correct ourselves. But you'll see what it's like to be a pure mathematician, and you yourself will be able to do some research. Maybe we should call it exploration. I like that word a little bit better than research. You're going to be in a position to explore mathematics directly. Our very first exploration, I think, will really catch your interest. We're going to be looking at a classical ancient problem with fresh eyes. And who knows, maybe we'll even discover some new things. It's the question of how do you solve polynomial equations? Naturally appealing even to high school students when they learn about polynomials and zeros of polynomials. But they learn that even though the quadratic formula is really cute, the cubic case developed by the Italians about 500 years ago is a lot harder, and it seems almost, you know, a barrier to really making more progress. And then if you do go to the undergraduate level and maybe take a course in Galois theory, which emerges from this desire to solve equations, you take this course and you learn some sophisticated things and normal extensions and connections with group theory and so on, a very nice subject. But at the end of it, can you solve polynomial equations better than you could at the beginning of it? Questionable. I'm going to be looking at things with a different orientation because I'm forced to view things in a different way from my fellow mathematicians, because I'm not allowed to, you know, waffle about infinite things at all. So that cuts out a whole range of things that people ordinarily talk about. But on the other hand, it opens new doors, new possibilities, and I'm going to show you the power of this new kind of thinking. All right? But this is not just the only thing we're going to be doing. We're going to be looking at a lot of different topics throughout mathematics. Graph theory, matrices, of course, geometry, affine and projective, especially important to learn some more projective geometry, algebra, probability, combinatorics, a key topic these days, set theory even, although no infinite set theory, or at least not in the usual way, group theory, topology, of course, calculus, and other things too. So a wide range of interesting topics. Some of them will certainly really, I think, grab your interest, and you'll want to say, yes, I can make some explorations here. I can maybe even discover something new. Okay, so this new series, Explore Research Level Maths, which is going to be happening on the channel Wild Egg Maths, make sure you subscribe. It's going to have the following basic orientation, that it's going to be informal and in-depth, and it's going to be an exploration with novel insights and new results. There will be computational tools that we will use, and I will be explaining these various things. So we'll end up actually touching base with a lot of interesting tools and techniques, but always in a kind of a focused context, okay? So we're going to be applying things, so you'll see things being used directly. I'm occasionally also, especially for you more advanced students, maybe there's some PhD students, and you will benefit enormously from this series. I'm going to give you some advice occasionally on research directions and just your general orientation that you should have to really profit as much as you can from your hard work in the research direction. But even amateurs, I'm going to be guiding you and showing you, you know, which areas are fruitful and areas which are not so fruitful. We'll be avoiding them or touching base with them only minimally. Okay, so in order to engage in this really super interesting development, I think, I'm going to ask you to join a channel membership for Wild Egg Maths. This is a way for you to support me in a small monthly way. And I think you're going to get really great value from the small amount of money that you're going to be helping me with. So if you come to a university and you want to do a PhD and get in one-on-one instruction with, you know, a professional mathematician, that costs tens of thousands of dollars every year. And I'm going to try to give you the kind of experience that you might get if you were one of my graduate students or maybe an undergraduate, okay? I'm going to explain a lot of things and you're going to learn so much. So I do encourage you to think about, you know, this kind of thing and joining and becoming a member. That'll mean that we also have a community of like-minded people and you can benefit a lot by bouncing ideas off each other, okay? So very, very exciting. I hope you'll join me for this. I'm Norman Wildberger. Thanks for listening.